started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Dick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Vermont Catamounts and the UCLA Bruins. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Bruins should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. Number one, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Secondly, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. Lastly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it. The pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
He makes a nice shot fake. They're working around the perimeter. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Inside. For two.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
And the ball goes out of bounds. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I tell you, you got to protect the bat.
He rejects it. On the outside, Rice handles the feed. Shoots it way off target. Too many dribbles and a steal.
Oh, what a high rise, a great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Haywood receives the pass. He throws it up from downtown. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Obvious foul. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
He attempts a jump hook. They still don't score.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seat.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Fed the low block. Tries for two. Off the rim and no good. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Trying to pack it inside. Number 42 with the fake. Trying to stay with him defensively, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Oh, what a terrific job. Exploded in the basket. Poor job defensively letting him get the ball that deep.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. The point guard receives the ball. He puts it in with contact and all. He keeps the dribble as they reset.
Step out on that screener.
He shoots from the angle. Sinks the shot. Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
Inside. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. They'll work it around the arc. Three. In and out. He cleans the glass. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle. Watch this! two-for-one opportunity.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
That defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
The power forward handles the pass. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The ball goes out of bounds. He'll regroup the offense. He does the sweet fake shot. For two. Perfectly executed. Easy basket.
We're aware is the D here, baby. Up and inside.
Defense giving some room. Leans in. Drains it. The Bruins are up by four. We've had a tooth and nail battle so far, Dick. What was the play of the half, do you think?
There was some nice inside play in the first half. We'll have to see which team continues to pound the ball inside in the second half.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. UCLA was on fire in that first half shooting from the field, partner.
I'll tell you, fire's not the word, man. They were blistering, just burning it up. We'll see if they can keep it up in the second half.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
And as you would say right here, Mr. Vitale, Flop City!
I tell you one thing, absolutely a flop, no doubt, Mr. Nessler.
Out of play. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
And they had it stolen away. One too many dribbles. Center gets the pass. On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice fake.
With a little baby hook.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Moving it around the perimeter. And the ball goes out of play. Things are going well, and it's going well for the school mascot, too.
I tell you, I love those mascots. They put so much enthusiasm and energy into it.
Gave it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The point guard takes the pass. There's a bad pass right to the defender. The power forward takes the feed. Kicks it out. He strokes it. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him.
The Bruins are one of the top teams in the country. They never have a night off.
Hey, you've got to love this program. Year after year, they're among the elite. Maintaining that level of excellence is often taken for granted.
He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Doesn't get much better than this in an NCAA tournament game. A close first half. The second half is more of the same, and Dick, it's going to come down to the final few possessions.
You know, Brad, they couldn't handle pressure defensively. I think rotating into the traps really created a nightmare.
Launches the three. Way off target. Copeland receives the ball. He puts it up. He gets the bucket to fall. We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. And, Dick, that puts the lead at 9.
9 points is surmountable. This is the time to start jacking threes.
He takes a three. And, Dick, no one can really find the touch from beyond the arc.
Hey, this is one of those nights that no matter how open you are, you just can't put it in, baby.
Lobs it. Tries for two. And he scores despite the hack.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He shows the sweet touch.
It's the replay, please.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul. And the clock stopped with a foul. Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
With the freebie. Misses the front end of the 1-1. A little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the top of the key. He doesn't get the hoop to fall.
Don't waste a lot of time. Ball right away.
Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
He goes to the line for the first time. Sinks it. Hits that one. Takes the shot. The Catamounts have found a player who cannot seem to miss it.
Braddy's on fire.
the line. No doubt about it. Makes the shot. Shot clock is dead. Three-pointer. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Jumped in front to take it away. Dick, can they eventually get it going from behind the arc, you think?
If they stop forcing him, sure.
He sure does, Dick, and why not? He and his team have all the momentum. I can't wait to see what unfolds next.
Hey, hey, he wants everyone to get up.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you've got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night game.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Rob, and you look at it and analyze it because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bruins came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.